A little over 6 years ago, I worked up the courage to send you a message on MySpace that went something along the lines of, "Hey, I know you don't know who I am, and please don't think I'm a creep, but I happened to come across your profile and couldn't help but notice how beautiful you are." Actually, looking back on it now, that was extremely creepy, and I'm not sure what you were thinking when you agreed to go on a date with me after that. All I can say now is, though it was a little creepy, it was easily the best decision of my life. A few days later, we decided the time had come for us to go on our first date. I still remember the drive to the batting cages with Joe in his truck like it was just a few days ago.
I remember being so nervous to go on our first date at the batting cages. But 10 minutes in, after kicking your butt, might I add, the nerves were gone and replaced with a flutter of excitement for what our future together could be.
You couldn't have squared that ball up any better than you did in that first swing. Then you turned and looked at me, shrugged your shoulders, and smiled. Right there in that moment, I knew something was different. I knew this wasn't just any first date. That little gesture of confidence and that beautiful smile will stick with me for a lifetime.
When Carson came into the picture, Tiffany came running out, you know. "Hey guys, guess what, I have a date. You have to make sure you're all wearing the perfect thing." She's like, "Okay." So Carson pulls up in his little striped tank top, bowl cut hair.
I remember the first time Carson pulled up where he goes, "Who is this guy?" And I seen him walk in and he takes off his hat, shakes my hand. I'm thinking, this guy's the biggest kiss butt I've ever seen in my life.
After that, she was so excited. That's all she'd ever talk about is Carson and how much she loved him. And I can't believe, like, he's my boyfriend. And I mean, watching them grow together is just an amazing thing.
I never saw Carson be so head over heels, per se, for a girl until he met you. There's nothing more noble or admirable than watching two incredible people come together as one in the unity of marriage.
You know, we love Carson to death. He is like a son that we've never had. Carson, you know, we respect you. The first day you walked in the door, you weren't a kiss butt. You were the real deal.
I promise to hold your hand every day, to kiss you, to tell you I love you, and to ask you how your day has been when you get home after a long day. Most importantly, I promise to love you no matter what, in good times and in bad times. I promise to always be there for you.
Over the years, we have grown closer and figured out how to essentially do life together. We have learned to celebrate the highs and hang tight through the lows. But most of all, love each other unconditionally, no matter what comes our way. I promise to be the best wife I can, and never stop loving you every second of every day, because I know that you are my person, and I couldn't imagine doing life with anyone else.
Part of me still can't believe that today I'm the lucky one who gets to marry you. And after 6 years, 2 months, and 7 days, the wait is finally over, and you will soon be Mrs. Ellington.
Do you take Carson to be your husband? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health?
I do.
Carson, do you take Tiffany to be your wife? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health?
I think it's obvious, but I do, yes.